In this video, I'm going to take you through how you can insert a calculated row into your Inforiver custom visual. And for this example, I'm going to use a P&L. So this is what the P&L data will typically look like. You can see we've got the revenue here. And the way the data comes through is that these items, revenue, expenses, cost of sales, will come through in the order in which they're in the data. But that order is not necessarily the correct order for your reporting purposes. And so I'm going to bring cost of sales and just move it up here above operating expenses so that I can now insert a new calculated row, which will end up being my gross profit. Now in this demo, I'm using Inforiver through the Power BI service. You could also do this in Power BI Desktop. And because I'm now going to make a change to my visual, I need to come into edit mode. So as you could see before, it's possible to move these rows around in read mode. But if you want to add any additional rows, you need to switch over to edit mode. So now that I'm in edit mode, I'm going to insert a row. Now I need it to be at the same level as the revenue, cost of sales, operating expenses. And so I basically need to insert a gross profit row above this row. So when you insert a row, it always goes above the selected row. So first of all, I select the bold operating expenses, and then I'll insert a calculated row, and I'll go to the UI, and this is going to be gross profit. Now, when I get to the formula section, you'll see I have the ability to refer to any of the other rows that are within the visual. Now there's two ways of doing that. I can either refer to them by using the formula language over here on the right hand side, or indeed I can go ahead and I can point to any of these items within the visual. So my gross profit is going to be revenue minus cost of sales. So I can click in here and go revenue, just hit the subtract, and then I can click here to get cost of sales. And just showing you the other way that I can do that, I can come in and just type in revenue, tab, subtract, cost of sales, tab. Now this include in total is very important because in some cases you'll actually have a master total at the top. Now I don't have that turned on at the moment. I'll just quickly come and turn that on. Totals actually don't make sense when you're doing a P&L, but just so that you can see what's happening. If I turn on the total, you can see that this number is 338. And if I then come in and edit that formula, so insert, manage, edit. And when I've got include in total, this 99 is included in that 338. If I turn that off and now update it, you'll see that it's not included. So both cases are valid. You just need to choose the correct one for your particular use case. And in this case, we don't need the total at all. So I'm just going back to turn that off. Now, before moving on, I just want to pause to appreciate what I've just done there. I've manually added a calculation inside a visual inside Power BI. Now this is very difficult to do in regular Power BI, and if you've ever tried to do a P&L, you'll be aware of how complex it is to generate a P&L. In general, Power BI is very good as long as all of the numbers in the columns need to be added up, but as is clear here, the gross profit is actually the revenue subtract the cost of sales, and this becomes very difficult to do in standard Power BI. So just appreciate how valuable that capability is. Okay, so continuing on the theme of inserting calculated rows, you can see here that I have my operating expenses, which includes all items in my operating expense. But let's say there was a requirement to break out the general and administrative expenses, and for me to see what percentage G&A is of total operating expenses. Now there are different ways to do this, and this can certainly be done in data modeling, and that may be appropriate, but it's also valid to add something like that directly within the visual, and I'm going to go ahead and do that now. Now, as I stated before, if I'm going to insert a new row, it's important to select the correct level before you insert a row. So if I select the taxes and try and insert a row here, I'm going to get another header level total, and it's going to be bold. It will be at the same level as revenue, cost of sales. And that's not what I want in this case. So I'm going to click on the other expenses. When I go to insert a row, it will be inserted above the other expenses. That's the default behavior, but I can come and move it afterwards. So I'm going to insert a new row, and this will be general and admin. And my formula, once again, if I go into the formula section here, I can now start to refer to the rows by using the mouse, or indeed I can use the formula language. Now, if I want to use the formula language, I need to fully qualify the location. So if I want to add, for example, rent as a part of G&A, I would type in OP, for operating expenses, tab, dot, rent. So that's the fully qualified address, if you like, for the operating expenses and rent. So let me add to that telephone. So operating expenses dot telephone. And as I showed you before, I can also use the mouse. So I can go ahead and point to office supplies, and I can also go ahead and point to depreciation. So there are the four items that I'm going to include in my general administration. Now, as I covered before, we don't want to include this total in the total, because if I was to do that, I would be doubling up on these four items. So I need to deselect this item. But now I've got this option to include in charts, and I'm going to tick this one on and come back and show you what this does shortly. I could put a description here if I like, but for now, I'm just going to go ahead and create that formula. Okay, so I'll leave this side pane open, because now what I want to do is add another row, because I want to know what's the percentage of general administration of the total operating expenses. So I want that one to go above other expenses. And so I can just come in here and insert a calculated row. And even though this general and admin is a manually calculated row, I can still refer to it within the formula language. So I can say it's the operating expenses dot general and admin tab divided by the operating expenses. And I don't want to include in totals. And this time I will leave this one unchecked. And once again, I'll come back and show you what that's about in a moment. Indeed, I'll come back and show you what this one does in a moment as well. So this is now G&A. So I'll update that one. Now I need to come in and apply some formatting. Notice when I click on this cell that I get this nice visual communication of what the input for this cell is. Same here, if I click here on this cell, notice you get this nice visual communication, and you can also see the fully qualified formula at the top here. So in the case of G&A percent, I'm going to come up and I'll click on the percentage. I'll leave the default 2 decimal points. Once again, anyone that's tried to do this in Power BI before in the standard visuals will know how very hard this is to do. So having different formatting within the same column is a very powerful feature of Inforiver. So now I've added my two additional calculated rows. A couple of things just as a refresher from one of my other videos. These pencil marks are here and they're on by default when you're in edit mode. Once I come in and switch to reading view, I have to save the report, they automatically get removed. And if you are in edit mode and you would like to turn them off, you can come into display and you'll see that this edit cell indicator allows you to turn them off while you're in edit mode. And the other point that I covered in one of the other videos is that if I come into the insert tab, we do have this audit capability. When I'm not clicking on any of the cells, we get an auditable list of all of the manual changes that have been made within this visual. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is just move these two new rows around. So really, I want other expenses at the top. And just so that it's clear to my users that this is an addition from above, I'm just going to come to the Home tab and I'll turn on a nice bold line above. And I might just multi-select these and come on and turn on some italics, just so that it's clear that these numbers are additive from above. Now, while I'm looking at the different formatting options, it is possible to change the font that is used inside Inforiver. This is the default font, Antique or Mono. The reason this font is used is look how cleanly the decimal places and the millions and thousands numbers line up on the screen. If I switch over to the standard Power BI font, which I certainly can do, just notice how much harder it is to read the underlying numbers on the screen. So you're free to change the font if you like, but this font has been selected for a very specific reason, to make the numbers very easy to read on screen. Now I'd like to come back to something that I mentioned before when I added these rows. If I come in here and show you the formula, you'll recall that I checked this box, including charts, for the general and admin. But if I come down here and edit the second row, that I didn't include in charts for this percentage. So the reason I did that is that if you select on one of these columns, I can come up here and use one of the standard charting capabilities from within Inforiver. So I can use this to visualize my data. Now notice that this 4.42 million does have a chart item rendered and this one doesn't. So that's what the include in chart checkbox does when you're writing a formula. If I want to return just to standard numbers, it'll switch back to numeric. What I'd like to do now is I'm going to come into my calendar and I'm going to bring in the calendar year and add that onto columns in my visual. And I'll also come up here and turn on a grand total column so that I can see the total for all of the years. Now, you recall there's another setting. If I come in here to edit this row, this evaluate columns before rows. And so what this is saying is it will always do the calculation in the columns first before it does the calculations in the rows. And so in this case, you can see that that means that the grand total calculations are done first and then any calculations from the rows. If I turn this off and click update, you'll see the implication of changing that setting. And so now what's happening is we're getting all of the rows evaluated first, and then we're adding up the grand total, and that doesn't make sense in this particular use case. But both are valid. It's just a matter of choosing the correct one for your particular use case. Now, one final thing to point out before I close this topic of calculated rows is that if I was to insert a row in here, insert a calculated row, it's very important that you don't point to the total row. So if I try to add in here an operating expenses and I leave include in total, if you did this in Excel, you would expect to get a circular reference, and exactly the same thing happens here. So just be careful. You need to determine whether you use include in total or not, and be careful of circular references. Now, in addition to inserting calculated rows, you can also insert static rows. So this is designed when you want to put some numbers or something else into one of your tables, but you really don't need to do any calculation. Now, you can do calculations in static rows, but that's not really what they were designed to do. So let's say I just want to put a target number. So arbitrarily, I'll just come in here. I'll insert a row. This time I'll add a static row, and this will be my target percentage. And I don't need to include it in the total, same as before. And I'm just going to put in, let's just say the target was 10.5% in 25. And then let's say it was 10% here. And let's say that we've got some declining numbers that we're after. So 0.09 and 0.09. Once I've added those static numbers, I can multi-select them, come up and apply the formatting. And for consistency, I might come here and apply the italics, and I'll also just move these around so that my target sits below the actual G&A percentage of expenses. So that's how you can use a static row in Inforiver.